Welcome to Juliet Kitchen with Chef Yasmin.
Today's recipe is this super easy, absolutely delicious pumpkin and red sweet potato soup. It's bursting with complex flavor that all works together. I do hope you'll stick around long enough to see how I make it.
Before we get started, I really do appreciate your subscription. Click the bell so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Enjoying the video? Give it a thumbs up. Thank you.
I have a beautiful pumpkin here and I have a red sweet potato. What I want to do is prepare the sweet potato and the pumpkin and get those roasted.
Carefully peel and chop the sweet potato. I like to use the red sweet potato because it's less sweeter than regular sweet potatoes. For the pumpkin, I'm using a very small baby pumpkin, or it's called pumpkin pie. To prepare the pumpkin, all I really do is cut it in half, remove the seeds, remove the skin, and then chop.
Okay, so I have the butternut squash and sweet potatoes here. I want to drizzle with extra virgin olive oil. About 3 tablespoons. You want enough oil to coat the vegetables well. I'm going to add in a little bit of red pepper flakes. I always like a little bit of heat, maybe 1/4 teaspoon. Season this with a little bit of ground cumin. It's a pretty strong flavor, so I only want about 1/4 teaspoon for this recipe. Fresh ground black pepper, salt, and then I like to add a little bit of maple syrup. This is an amber maple syrup, but you could add whatever type you have. About 1 tablespoon. A few sage here that I picked fresh from my garden. And I'm going to chop these. I'm going to put some of it in the roast.
My preference is to always use fresh herbs where possible, but you can always substitute dried herbs.
About 1 teaspoon.
Whenever replacing fresh herbs with dried, always use a lot less of the dried herbs. For example, 1/4 teaspoon dried or less to 1 teaspoon fresh. The vegetables should be thoroughly coated with the oil.
I'm gonna make sure it's in a single layer. Into my preheated oven.
I'm going to use porcini powder to flavor the broth. So I'm using dried porcini and grinding it into a powder. Powder is also available for purchase online. To make the broth, I start by sauteing onions and celery in extra virgin olive oil. Season with a pinch of salt. Cook 2 minutes. Add in scallions, ginger, garlic, turmeric root, fresh sage. Cook 30 seconds.
A few seconds and then I add in my spice mix. And this is really just 1/4 teaspoon ground cumin and 1/4 teaspoon red pepper flakes.
Cook 30 to 60 seconds.
What I'm gonna do now is add in my magic powder. I would use 1 tablespoon of the porcini powder.
The porcini powder adds so much flavor to the soup.
Here is adding water.
If you prefer, you could skip the porcini powder and just add a vegetable stock. Be sure to season with salt. Bring to a boil and cook 15 minutes. The pumpkin and red potatoes are finished. They look beautiful and they're nice and tender.
The stock has been simmering for about 15 minutes, so all I need to do now is add in the roasted veggies, pumpkin and sweet potato.
It smells amazing in here. All I really want to do is simmer this for about 10 minutes to marry the flavors.
Okay, the pumpkin and the sweet potato has been simmering in the stock or broth for about 10 minutes. And now what I want to do is puree using my handy dandy immersion blender.
Instead of using an immersion blender, you can also pour the soup mixture into a blender and puree until smooth or to your likeness. Also, if it's too thick, you can add a little bit of water.
Now what I really want to do is taste it. Wow. That is amazing. A couple of other things that I want to do. I'm going to turn back on my heat and I want to add in some kale.
Instead of kale, you could certainly add in spinach. If you prefer, you can chop the kale, but I like the nice chunky pieces in the soup. This is nice and thick, and that's how I prefer it.
Wow, this is beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful.
Feel free to serve this with a drizzle of extra virgin olive oil, fresh scallions, and toasted pumpkin seeds. The toasted pumpkin seeds taste very nutty and have a nice pop and texture on the palate.
It's my favorite time. Tasty. It smells so delicious in here. Mmm. Wow. The crunch of that beautiful roasted pumpkin seed. Very nutty. The flavor is impeccably rich. Very balanced, not too sweet. The red pepper flakes, just a hint of it. I think the amount of each of the ingredients was perfect. Wow. This is a must try. It's so delicious.